In this lesson, we're going to use a corner pin and an edge blur to replace the screen. Okay, so in our last lesson, I challenged you to try to get track 2 and 3 to match up perfectly with your corners. So I've gone ahead and done that in between lessons. If you didn't get a chance to do that, then you can just pick up here where we are starting at 09_begin in your project files. Okay, so now we're ready to introduce the image that we want to track along with these 4 points. So go ahead and grab your reference files folder, and we're going to grab the rotating vector city. So go ahead and just drop that onto your timeline. Okay, so I can kind of zoom back here a little bit, and you'll see that the rotating city I have is only 640 by 360 instead of the 1280 by 720. So that's going to be a little bit smaller than the shot that we were working with before. So that's going to present a little bit of an issue that we'll be able to clear up later on. But first of all, what we need to do is to add a corner pin node. So that's basically what's going to distort this data into fitting onto the area that we've tracked here. So basically all you have to do is just have that read node selected, then hit the tab key and type in corner, and you see corner pin comes up, and that's going to give you that. Now what if I want to look at these two things together? I need to use a merge node to be able to view the read node of my vector city on top of the read node of my footage. So let's just hover over our node graph, hit the tab key and type in merge. I didn't have anything selected, so it just dropped it right there onto the node graph. And if you remember, the B pipe is always going to be your background, so we can plug that into tracker 2 that has all the background information over here of our plate. And then our foreground is going to be plugged into the corner pin node, which will be all of the foreground information in a moment. So right now we've got the foreground information right here with the corner pin node, but it's not being distorted yet. Now I want to view the merge, so I'm going to go ahead and drop that viewer node onto the merge so it resizes this for me so that I'm seeing kind of that full size, and I see how this is just kind of stuck down here. So because that corner pin node has been applied, you see how the 4321 is written in the corners. So basically this is going to be pinned to tracker 4, this will be pinned to tracker 3, this corner will be to 2, and this one to 1. So you can see why it's important, that order that I told you of kind of which order, which corner you want to be the upper left-hand corner of your image is the one that you want to be track 4, basically. That's just how the corner pin node works. So again, we're going to want to be hooking some data together from our tracker to our corner pin node. So what I'm going to do is just close out of the merge node for a second. And we don't even need the tracker node open anymore either. We only need the corner pin for now. And all you have to do is right click where it says 2-1 and tell it to link to. Let's pull this over here just so you can see everything. Right click, go to link to, choose tracker 2. And then because it says 2-1, you'll choose track 1, tracker 2, track 1. And you can see that over here, just middle clicking, that's been kind of sucked onto that track 1 point. Then let's come over here and do the same for track 2. So right click over that animation menu, go to link 2, tracker 2, track 2. And then the same for 3 and 4. Pretty straightforward once you get the hang of it. Track 4. And that looks like that is in place. Now, sometimes you're going to have a problem where your image does not perfectly sit on your phone. So, looks like ours is doing a pretty good job of snapping into that place. And the reason why it's doing that is because of what we had selected when we dropped in the corner pin node. We had the read node selected, but if you didn't and then you simply hooked the corner pin node in, it might not have the right center point, and so you're going to have a problem. But all you have to do is come over here to that From tab and click Set to Input, and that's going to snap it back into place. So if you just did what I did and maybe you skipped that step of having the read node selected, can happen to anybody, but it will make your image look a little weird. So if you're having trouble, if you do this on your own and your image doesn't automatically snap into place, try clicking Set to Input and just see what happens once you have these linked up and it still doesn't look right. Okay, so now we have a pretty awesome looking image here. I mean, there's a little bit to be desired as far as the way the screen is integrated, but we'll be able to fix that in a moment. But it really looks like this video is on her screen as far as the way that it's deforming to those points. Now, there's a few things that we can change to make it a little bit better integrated. So one of the first things I want to do is to add an edge blur. And that's just going to give this edge a little bit less of that hardness that you see there. And most screens don't project all the way to the very edge of the screen. So you get a little bit of black here. Now, we've already gotten that just because of the way we've tracked it. But adding edge blur is going to help even more. So we want that edge blur to happen after the corner pin and before the merge node. So let's go ahead. We'll just hover over this area here, hit the tab key and type in edge. Edge blur is going to pop up, and we'll just pop that in between the merge and the corner pin node. And you can pull that over there. And then let's just see what happens if we pull this all the way up, kind of what it does. So I like to kind of play with the slider to figure out, you know, how far I can push it and then just figure out a good area. So it looks like for this one, probably somewhere between 4 and 5 is a good place. If you feel like it's too much, maybe take it down between 3 and 4. And that's just going to help this area here to feel a little bit better integrated. Now, in our next lesson, we're going to learn how to make it look even better integrated by reintroducing the reflections from our screen into our composite and changing a few other properties just to really make this shine. So stick around, and we're going to finish up the polish for this little shot in our next lesson.